All right, guys.
What is the morning weight?
One's 41.6. These pants are probably like a pound, so I would say like 140.6 morning weight. Not too bad.
Alright, good morning, guys. Right now it's 8 a.m. We're heading to BMW to get my tires replaced. I went to like two tire shops around here, but I don't think they want to work on my car because one of them. So the first location I went to, they were like, "Oh, we don't have a lift fucking low enough for your car or some shit." So then they transported my wheels to another location, which we waited 30 minutes for, and my car was literally just parked outside, wasn't getting worked on. And the excuse they gave me was, "Oh, your car has spacers, so we can't work on your car." So I was like, what the fuck? I was like, who the fuck ever says that? But anyways, we're going to BMW, getting my shit replaced. Got Michelin Pilot Sport, all season fours. But yeah, I'll see you guys there. And yeah, I have bald ass tires. Alright, guys, we just got here. Let me turn the car off, it's too loud. Alright, basically, these Michelin tires are mine, so we're gonna be putting, where the fuck is the address? We're gonna be putting these on here. I currently have the Pirellis, and they're like old as fuck. So, yeah, basically fucking sliding on the road. I've been sliding on the road every single day. But yeah, these are bald as fuck, and we're gonna get those on here. I'm thinking of going to a gym right now while I wait. It's gonna be like 15-20 minute walk, but I think since I'm waiting, I don't wanna get into a workflow. Cause when I work, I like working for like a long period of time, and I'm just gonna make myself some breakfast and then head to the gym probably, get a back workout in, do some deadlifts. Haven't deadlifted in a while, but we'll see what I could do. I'm off like 4.5 hours of sleep because I have to wake up so early, But yeah, and I was bulking last night, so I was at 2,000 calories, and then I ate a sandwich, which was, I would say it's a good like 700 calories, 800 calories. And then I ate like 10 chicken nuggets, which is around 500, and then I finished some Auntie Anne's pretzel nuggets, so probably around 300. So I was at 2,000, and I got to pretty much like 3,500. But yeah, so I'm gonna make some breakfast, and then we're gonna head to the gym. Yo, is it just me, or like, I can't train on an empty stomach? Like, if my stomach is empty, I don't know how some people do it, maybe they're fasted, they're used to it, but I literally cannot train unless I have like some sort of food in my stomach, or else I'm just gonna be so hungry. I'm gonna feel dizzy, I'm gonna feel nauseous, and I'm not gonna feel strong, I'm not gonna have a good workout. So I literally need like some sort of food. And I think the best times is like at night, because like you digest all your food, you have your meals. But I literally cannot work out about any meal. So for breakfast, we're gonna have some chicken and rice. This piece of chicken is fucking massive, but we're gonna have some chicken and rice on, take 300 milligrams of pre-workout, hit the gym, come back from the gym, and then we're gonna do a bunch of work until like lunchtime. Or maybe I'll have a meal at like 2-3 p.m. and then I'll have dinner, I'll have more snacks in between, or just stuff to like up the calories, and I think that'll be like the eating diet for the day. Alright, so I finished cooking a meal. It's just some sunny side up eggs with chicken and rice. Pretty fucking basic.
But I'm gonna be eating this and then I'll wait like 30 minutes to digest it. And then we're gonna hit the gym, hit some deadlifts. I don't know if I can go heavy, but we'll see what we can do. I feel like I'm gonna enjoy content creation as a whole more now that I don't really do it for the money. Like back then, I wanted to, like, my goal in life is always to inspire as many people as possible. Like, I want to go on podcasts. I want to reach like millions of people and be able to make an impact on their life, inspire them through my journey, through my progress. Like a lot of these skinny kids, I didn't realize that they started the gym because of me. And that shit means a lot to me. But like when it's online, like you don't really grasp like an actual person like telling you that. It's just DMs and words on the screen. So you don't really like understand the magnitude of like how much you really change someone's life until you meet them, until you're shaking their hand like, yo bro, like you inspire me and all this. I think a big part of like why I was starting my YouTube before was just to become like a fitness influencer so I can make a career off of it. And I think there's nothing wrong with that because, you know, everybody has to make like bread some one way or another. And fitness career is pretty good. If you could get enough people to watch you, like you can make a lot of money. Like you look at Sam Solik, for example, he makes like 30 minute videos and people watch him every single day. But I think with this journey, it's gonna be a lot better because I'm not in it for the money at all. I'm just doing this to keep myself accountable because I don't think I would have made this meal if I probably would have just made like some bullshit ass meal. But since I'm doing it in front of the camera, like I kind of want to get like the best meals possible online, obviously. And I think if I wasn't doing this in front of camera, like I probably wouldn't be bulking as hard and keeping myself accountable. So having people to take on a journey with me, like just keeps me accountable for everything. And I kind of just want to like document my whole winter journey. And I know I'm gonna hit 170 like pretty soon. I'm gonna be eating a lot. And anytime I really like put my mind to something and I actually like focus on it, I get it done. So there's just no doubt that number is coming. I'm gonna be that way and I'm gonna be huge. As for like my goals, obviously 170 pounds, but for bench, I wanna hit 315 and I wanna get back to squatting. So another big part of like why I kind of fell out of love with the gym was because of my injuries and my knees started hurting. My elbows was like not good. My shoulders, every time I would do dumbbell like presses, it would hurt my shoulder really bad at the bottom position where you're like, you know, bent like that with a lot of weight on your shoulders. So that would hurt a lot. And then the other thing was like my wrist when I dropped a dumbbell on myself. So it was a lot of injuries. Like my knees still hurt. Like I could barely hit legs, but I'm gonna try to get back into everything. Deadlifts. My back was hurting at some point, so literally like all these injuries just made me fall out of love with the gym. But I'm gonna try to get back to like everything and just get back in the flow. I feel like if I start working out like pretty normally again and I eat normally and I start moving weight, like I think my joints will be like a lot better, a lot stronger, and I'm gonna be like working on some mobility in the gym. So I'm gonna finish this meal and I'll catch you guys in the gym. I'm not gonna lie, we might have to save this. I'm actually about to throw up, and I think part of that is because I usually like eat very small breakfast and then I eat like a big lunch, or I just combine the two and I never, like I usually don't even have breakfast, but this is a really big fucking breakfast. I'll probably just eat it after the gym, but all right. I'm gonna head to the gym, like I'm literally about to throw up. I'm trying to finish the fucking food for the video, but I'm literally about to throw up, like this is so bad. Every fucking bite, I'm just gagging. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the gym. So I was just walking to the gym, and I just realized that I forgot my pre-workout, so now I gotta go back for my pre-workout, and I'm about to just Uber there, but I'm probably just gonna end up walking. I hate spending money that doesn't need to be spent. Like, I don't give a fuck how much money I have. Like, it's a fucking 15 minute walk to a gym. I don't, like,
I don't really care. Like, all my clothes are, like, other than this was, like, part of my vision board, I think. Like, my friend told me to get a Montclair at the start of, like, my entrepreneur journey. And then I was like, okay, I made a bunch of money. I'm just gonna get the Montclair. Like, I think it was, like, this is, like, the only piece that's, like, part of my vision board. Like, I've never bought designer. And probably, like, I might, but, you know, I'm not gonna say I won't. And then fucking people pull up this video and then see that I say I won't. But it's, like, the only piece I have. And I just hate spending money that doesn't need to be spent. So I'm gonna get back, take the pre, and then we're gonna walk back to the gym. All right, so I have Rise Ring Pop pre. So we're gonna take one scoop of this. Is 390 milligrams of caffeine, so that is fucking crazy. But we're gonna take 300 milligrams of this. Oh shit, that's a full scoop. So around this, maybe like that much. Might be a little over 300, but it's fine. Because I want to hit a heavy deadlift session today. I just ate. I've been eating. I've been bulking back up. So, hopefully, I'm pretty strong. I don't know how my back's going to get used to, like, the heavy weight. But really hoping for a good session. Holy shit. I don't know why I licked that powder. But I'm going to take this on the way to the gym. And then I might talk to you guys. It's low-key raining kind of hard right now, but I don't know why. I just never, like, really use umbrellas. Like, from a kid, like, I don't think I'm cool for doing this, by the way, but I just never really use umbrellas. I always wear, like, weatherproof or, like, waterproof jackets. Sometimes my sweatpants will get, like, wet. My socks will get a little wet. But I think the rain is beautiful. Like, I like the drizzle down on my hair. If it's, like, raining really hard, like, I'll put my hood on and shit, but I think it's just, like, mellow. It's, like, a good vibe. The rain's coming down. As long as, like, it's pretty gentle, not, like, harsh fucking raining cats and dogs, it's fine. But, yeah, I never really use umbrellas. Another thing I want to, like, improve on with this whole, like, YouTube stuff is I've never been good at, like, talking with, like, a flow. So that's something I really want to improve on, just talking to a camera, just being as natural as possible. And I think I'm a lot better when I'm talking to someone else, but I'm pretty awkward in front of the camera because I'm literally just talking to a fucking screen, and, you know, I can't really collect my thoughts as well. But I think the thing that will help a lot with that is just talking in more segments and talking a lot slower. So making sure I know what I'm saying next. Like, taking a pause instead of saying, like, or, you know, a filler word. I feel like that will help a lot. And that's something I really want to do for this journey as well. Like, I don't really care how much views my YouTube videos get. I want to document this for me. And then if people want to come along for the journey, they could come along for the journey and then, you know, be inspired, be motivated to hit some new goals or to bulk or whatever your goal may be for this winter. But yeah, I want this to hold me accountable. I want to improve my speaking a lot, and I want to, like, be more natural in front of the camera, because that's a really important skill. Especially as, like, a business owner, you want to be able to talk to people and not be awkward. So that's something I want to improve on. And I don't know, I just be yapping, but I think the best videos are the ones where you yap, especially on YouTube, where it's long form and people actually want to, like, connect with you and be able to relate to you. But yeah, that's what I want to do. My videos are mostly going to be, like, pretty, like, uncut, authentic videos of me just talking. But I think a lot of people will resonate with that. And I think I'll be able to inspire people, because I do both business and I do the gym. But I don't want my account to be just about the gym. Like, I don't want to have the gym in every single video. Like, I want to be able to build an audience where they could resonate with me without the gym. So just watching me for me, because I'm going to be taking a lot of, like, business trips, vacations and stuff. And if I'm able to vlog those and still, like, get decent views, that would be great. But this channel is not about views. But I still want to have an audience that, like, resonates with content outside the gym. So I'm gonna be doing a lot of, like, mixture, but, like, most of my days are just working though. Like, I just sit home on the computer and I work all day. So I have a pretty boring life. Other than when I take trips and stuff outside the country or like to Miami or wherever maybe. But I want to be able to vlog those and show you guys all like the good fun experiences as well. But I'm done yapping. See you guys in the gym. Part about getting back into the gym is just how weak I am. I just did some form up at 225, focusing on slab pose and, you know, just trying to get the weight back up and the volume and getting used to deadlifting again and making sure my back's good. I was out there hitting 335 for two, like that second rep felt like a PR, and it used to be like really easy for me. But usually, like when I get back into a lift, it takes me like 3 workouts to like get back to where I am if I'm at like a similar weight than where I was before. If I drop weight, obviously I'm gonna be weaker, but I think it's gonna be another lift or two before we could hit like 365 for reps. If not, I'll just work my way back up. It's fine, I have the muscle memory, so it shouldn't be too hard to get back to where I was. But it just really sucks, and it's really like mentally taxing just not being able to lift the weight that you used to be able to lift, and so much weaker now. But I understand that it's all temporary, and I'm gonna be able to lift the weight like just in a few workouts. I know I will be able to. And then I'm on the road to 500 pounds conventional. I don't fuck with sumo. I don't think my leverages are good for sumo either. But just gotta be doing a lot of form work, doing some volume, probably like some 3x5 workouts, and then doing some hypertrophy after. But I'm about to go hit some hypertrophy, so I'm gonna record that, and then see you guys at the end of it.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.
not too bad, but we just finished the workout. Really good fucking workout for hypertrophy part of it. My deadlifts is obviously a lot weaker, but you know, we're gonna build back up to 405 and hit a bunch of PRs in this bulk, get stronger, get heavier, and we're just gonna hit a lot of PRs. So I'm not too worried about the deadlift. First deadlift session back in like a while, so not worried about the deadlift. It's gonna go up eventually. Hopefully the wind's not too bad, but my back was looking really fucking wide there. So I think that's the first time like I was pretty satisfied with like posing in a while. Every time I pose, I just fucking hate my body, but my back actually looks pretty good there, so I'm pretty happy about that. Walking on my I'm on my way home. We're gonna go pick up my car soon, and then just gonna lock in for the rest of the day. Probably gonna finish the chicken and rice, and then make another meal in between. All right, the wind finally stopped, so I can actually talk again. But one thing I want to talk about is like kind of my nervousness in the gym to film. So it isn't about like other people really judging me, but to in their eyes, it's like, why is this skinny kid fucking filming himself and his fucking twig arms? Why is he filming in the gym when there's other bodybuilders in there who are not even filming? Why is he not just focused on working out? And that's something I really struggle with, because maybe it's just in my head, maybe people are not thinking that, but I feel like there are a lot of people who think that, and especially the people who are like, who don't really have a platform, who don't really understand content creation. And then when they find out about me, it's even worse. It's like, why does this kid have 100k? There's like nothing special about him. But I want to pave the way for like just the people starting out, because you see all these big guys, right? They're not relatable. You can't get to where they are and you can't progress with them. So with my journey, I think the reason why people resonate with me so well is because people could actually relate to me. And I'm not the biggest dude, I'm not the strongest dude, but I'm like relatively strong for my body weight. And I'm trying to bulk up, and it's really hard. And for a lot of the skinny kids out there, it's also really hard for them. So, you know, they could relate to how hard it is for us to bulk and for us to make progress in the gym. So me showing them my progress inspires them and motivates them to make their own progress. All right, so what I was saying was, basically I'm this small kid in the gym, you know, I don't have too much muscle mass. Oh, my cat's video bombing again. But anyways, I have this like perception in my head that these people are just judging me, even though they might not even be judging me. They might just be like, oh, like, does this kid do YouTube? Does this kid do like TikTok? Like, what does he do? Like, maybe they're just questioning it. But I just want to pave the way for like the skinny people and showing them that it's possible. Even though like it's really hard for me to record in the gym sometimes, like I get really nervous. I have all these big dudes around me just watching me, and a way I kind of like coped with that over the years was I try to lift heavy, just to like justify me filming myself. Because if I don't lift heavy, it's like, why is this guy lifting like 225 on deadlift and he's recording himself lifting 225? It's not even a PR, he's just recording his sets. Like, why is it so normal to him? And I kind of just like cope by like, you know, trying to hit like super heavy weights. And that's why I powerlift. But if I didn't record, like I would still try to like lift heavy, because I don't know, it's just like an ego boost in a way. Like if you guys powerlift, like you guys just want to chase the next big numbers and, you know, climb the ladder and get to like 5 plates, 6 plates. So it's kind of that whole process, but when you record, it makes it so much worse, because everyone's just staring at you, and especially if you're a skinny kid, like, it's like embarrassing. Like, if you're benching less than like 2 plates, it's pretty embarrassing. It's like, I kind of have to justify in my head, like, okay, I'm doing this for something bigger. I'm doing this to inspire other people. I'm doing this to, you know, build my following and build my audience. And oh, Yo, relax. Yo, what? Alright. But yeah, I kind of have to justify all of that in my head. But just wanted to like kind of talk about that. And if you guys do film in the gym, just know that like you might start small, but you are documenting your journey, and it's so worth it to document your journey, because at the end of it, you get to look back at everything and then appreciate like all the hard days. You know, you're gonna have hard days, you're gonna have days where like you don't lift much, but those are, you're gonna be able to look back at those days. You're gonna have progress pictures, videos, and everything, and it's gonna be worth it to like document everything. So if you're starting out, take a lot of videos, take a lot of pictures. That's something I'm glad I did, but that's because of TikTok. If it wasn't for TikTok, like I wouldn't have taken all those pictures and videos, and I wouldn't have stuff to look back on. So if you're starting out, like don't be like, the worse you look, the better the transformation. So just think about that. Like, think about how good your comparison is gonna be to the future you, like after like 3 months or something. But yeah, like, the worse you look, the better the comparison and the story. I'm gonna be finishing the chicken and rice, and then hopefully I'm gonna pick up my car soon. And we're gonna have Michelin tires instead of Pirellis, which I'm really excited about. But yeah. All right guys, it was $168 to get these installed. We got the Michelin Pilot Sport All Season 4s, so perfect for the winter. And then by the time these are bald, it'll be summer, and then I'll get some Michelin Pilot Sport 4S's. So that'll be fun. But I'm about to head back and do more work. So let's go for a drive. Our last update about the car. I had to get my 15 millimeter spacers removed, cause this shit was literally like, I don't know if you guys could see from the last video, but it was literally hitting like right here and right here. So I had to get that removed. I don't think I'm gonna buy new spacers. It's fucking Q4. Like, I got so much shit to do. So this is how it's gonna be. There's like a bigger gap now, but spacers are still on this, so you know, you could definitely see a difference. And all right guys, we're at the grocery store. We're getting more eggs because I used all 4 eggs earlier for the chicken and rice and the eggs. So we're getting more eggs, 36 more eggs. Should last at least like a week or two. So we're getting these eggs. Yeah, 18.
In a week?
Some shit like that. Six a day, that's 36. All right, anyways, we're gonna go back. We're gonna make dinner, and then I'll eat dinner, and then we'll end the vlog there. All right guys, so for dinner, we're gonna have some chicken and some cod with some rice. I don't know how much calories this is, but I'm gonna eat cookies later, and I might eat some ice cream. I think that's about it, but I'm gonna finish this meal, and then I'll wrap up the video. All right guys, I finished the meal. I'm gonna eat some cookies later and get a few more calories in. But here's a reminder that you don't need any fancy equipment to film. Like, you just have to be you. So whether, like, I don't care how much views this video get, if it blows up, great. If it doesn't, you know, I had fun making it, and I had practice talking to myself, and that was the authentic me. So I just want an audience that resonates with me, that wants to watch me for me. So you don't need any fancy camera equipment when you start. You don't need no 4K 60fps camera for like $2,000 with like another $1,000 lens. You don't need any of that. When I first started my TikTok and I grew to 100K, I literally put a water bottle and my phone on the floor. I recorded a bunch of shitty ass quality videos, but it was more about the concept of the video and if people could find you relatable and if people like you for your journey. Eventually I got the tripod for like recording vlogs, bench vlogs, deadlift vlogs, squat vlogs, whatever. But most of the time it was just this water bottle and my phone. So you don't need any fancy equipment. You just have to start. And starting is the hardest part, but once you start, you kind of just experiment with like what works, what doesn't work. Let's just say a video got, you know, 100,000 views, and another video got 100 views. Like, why did the 100,000 views video go viral? It's because there's a bigger audience for it and people could resonate with it. So when you're starting out, you don't need fancy equipment. Just start. Literally just start. I don't give a fuck. Like, if you're recording 720p videos, just start, just practice and experiment, see what works, and you guys will find something that works for you, and you guys will find an audience for you. So I'll see you guys in the next video tomorrow, but I had a lot of fun making this, so I'm very excited for this winter journey, and I'll see you guys soon.